Good day, you beautiful ones in Christ, love, honour and glory to each and every one of you. Today I'm looking into the book of Romans, talking about sin and the flesh. When your flesh has been crucified for all time, to free you from the bondage of sin which brings death, this is what happens. Your flesh has been crucified for all time to free you from the bondage of sin which brings death. And when a man dies, he's finished with sin. And this happens whether you're alive or the day you die. And through faith, we believe, having died with Christ, we shall return to life. Christ having died and resurrected to eternal life means being justified through faith. We too are resurrected into eternal life. The process takes place in the spirit now when a believer comes to Christ. This is why it is written, you have died to Christ. You have died to yourself. You've been resurrected into the newness of life forever. And meaning you will never die. And meaning your sins are forgiven forever. Those who do not come to Christ in their fleshly life remain under sin until they die. And so the penalty of sin remains until they die. Because once you die, you are free from the bondage of sin. And having died, they then receive the gift of eternal life. For as we read, where there is death, there is no sin. Those in Christ in the flesh and spirit do not let sin dominate their life. This goes on until they give up their mortal bodies, knowing they will receive and be clothed with immortality. They are free from death and sin. And so, that fear of death is removed forever, knowing that they have eternal life. The sons and daughters serve righteousness and become slaves to righteousness and not to their sin. And when under the law of ruin, there is no obligation to righteousness. But now, under the law of the Spirit, you become obligated to it. You become obligated to righteousness. This is the choice we all have. And so become justified as a reward. A believer is dead to the law, so not under any obligation to it. And being made alive in Christ means, for example, a woman can marry another man because her non-believing husband or her husband is spiritually dead. Sorry, let me put that again. A woman can marry another man. Under the law, she couldn't, or she would be called an adulteress. But since she has died to self, died to flesh, and resurrected in the spirit, she is no longer under any obligation or accusation of adultery. So she is free to marry another, because she is no longer under law. And through the body, a believer can give themselves to another husband which is Christ. Your union is not without your partner, is not with your partner, but with Christ. So that was just a little discussion about being baptized into death and resurrected into life. And in summary, you were only under law until you died to Christ. Once you die to yourself, you died with Christ, but you have been resurrected with Christ because you are not left in the grave. You are resurrected in the Spirit and have become one with Christ. So while you were in the flesh, you were obligated under the law to keep the law. But once you have died to yourself and then resurrected into the newness of life, into the new covenant, you are no longer obligated under the law. And this is how you can have life more abundant without the obligations, without the condemnation, without sin, without death, and without the curse of the law. And so too, you have a life more abundant, free, knowing that you have eternal life and that you will never die. Peace and love.